What's up, everyone? Kobanermani456 here today, presenting to you all a brand new playthrough on a Nintendo GameCube game that many people have requested me to do for quite a while, so here it is!
Can you feel it? Can you feel it? Oh.
Alright, I'm going.
Welcome to the sun-drenched tropical paradise of Isle Delfino. We're so pleased to welcome you to our beautiful home. Come enjoy a natural wonderland to which we've added the world's finest resort facilities, a spectacular amusement park, and succulent seafood. All this and more await you on Isle Delfino. Come relax and let us refresh your body and spirit.
And there it is. My next playthrough on my channel is going to be Super Mario Sunshine. I am so excited about doing this playthrough because, like I said, I have had a ton of you all, my fans and viewers, ask me to do this game for quite a while and felt that now is the time to start off this playthrough. So if you are one of the people who asked me to do this game or really excited about me doing it, make sure to go ahead and smash that like button. It really, really helps out a ton. Let's see if we can hit the like goal of 3,500 likes. I believe we can do it. Believe in all of you Kobanermites, and want to thank you all for all the support. It really, really means a ton. But anyway, yeah, we're going to go ahead and start off a game right here, and okay, cutscene started. But yeah, let's go ahead and start off the game. I'm actually going to have to delete one of my save files right here, so I'm going to go ahead and delete this real quick, erase this. Alright, but anyway, before we actually do get started in this game, I want to go ahead and go into the question of the day for this video right here. The question of the day is actually very simple. Let me know in the comments below, what do you all think about this game? Is it one of your favorite 3D Mario games? Is it your favorite 3D Mario game? Or do you not like it at all? Would love to hear your thoughts in the comments below, and yeah. Anyway, let's go ahead and get started on our new adventure in Super Mario Sunshine.
What's this icky paint like goop? It's moving!
Now, boys, don't touch that stuff. I am most concerned with the well-being of the princess in this dreadful heat. Master Mario, if you would, cross over to that shore and find some assistance.
Mario, please be careful. I have a bad feeling about this.
Alright, so here we are. Now actually having control over this game, and we are playing as Mario. We got Princess Peach right here, we have old Grandpa Toad right here, and then Toad himself. So yeah, really, really hyped about doing this playthrough. Like, you all have no idea. But anyway, we gotta come over here, and we run into a little friend. Who the heck are you?
Power up complete. Thank you for purchasing this item from Gad Science Incorporated.
I swear, Mario looks like Ron Jeremy so much.
Subject identified as Mario, resident of the Mushroom Kingdom. Data storage complete. I am Flood, a flash liquidizer ultra-dousing device. I hope to be of assistance.
Hey, look at us all geared up.
Proceeding.
Got our new toy.
With user instruction. Use the R button to shoot water from my tank. If you press the R button all the way down, you can stop and shoot. You can then use the control stick to aim in any direction. Press the X button to switch to the hover nozzle. You can then press the R button to hover in the air for a short time. If this tank is empty, no water can be sprayed. To refill tank, enter a body of water and press the R button. Instructions complete. Proceed.
Alright, no, we don't want to hear that explanation again, but I do like how they have tutorials in this game, because Flood is kind of like a new mechanic to the Mario series. It's something that, when this game came out, we had never seen anything like this at all, so I'm glad that they do kind of explain a lot of stuff. Anyway, let's talk to this dude right here. He's kind of jumping and hollering, "Hallelujah in the sanctuary," but no, he's actually saying, "Help! Help you? Are you crazy? We're the ones who need help! Take that water pump and clean the airstrip, you! You!" Okay, then. Get a little spray in the face. Alright, so yeah. As he said, you press the R button to kind of spray at stuff, and you can spray away this goop. You can press, you can kind of like do a circle around with the analog stick and do a spin jump like that. You can press R and then do a backflip by pressing the A, that backflip though. And then you can also switch to the hover nozzle right here by pressing the X button, which gives you some extra vertical and horizontal range. So pretty cool. Flood is awesome. But anyway, we gotta come over here and clean up this goop, because it looks like Epic Mickey is back. Since I didn't finish my playthrough on that, he got a bit upset and decided to spill all his goop all over the place in Mario Sunshine. Anyway, we got this ginormous piranha plant monster that we gotta spray in its mouth. Just three times, because three is the, what is it? Three is the magic number, and there we go. Alright, here we go. Ooh, dive into that! That was freaking awesome. We were moving during the cutscene. But yeah, see right there, once you spray away that piranha plant goop monster from Epic Mickey, then you can actually get yourself your first shine. Which, what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna dive into it! And there we go. Our first sunshine has been acquired.
Nice work, Mario!
Quite an unusual device. Is it some sort of pump?
I am Flood. Glad to meet you.
Hey, someone's coming!
Is now in session.
As you are no doubt aware, someone has been senselessly defacing Fair Isle Delfino using some paint-like substance. The accused is charged with polluting our beautiful home and, yes, endangering our very way of life. Indeed, how can one not be aware of what is going on? Though it is daytime in Delfino Plaza, our poor residents tremble beneath the veil of darkness. Expert shine scholars have determined that this darkness has arisen because all of our guardians, the shine sprites, have vanished from their gathering spot at the shine gate. The reason? It's quite obvious. This horrible graffiti is to blame. Behold this sketch of the perpetrator based on eyewitness descriptions. The truth is obvious. The guilty party sits among us. It is none other than Mario!
Objection.
Phoenix Wright reference.
Overruled! I judge the defendant guilty as charged. I hereby order the defendant to clean this entire island. Until Isle Delfino is completely free of his vile handiwork, Mario shall not be allowed to leave. Court adjourned.
I'm getting a strong sense of deja vu here. Shadow Mario, Shadow the Hedgehog, Mario, been accused by colorblind people.
Are indeed troubled by pollution, but the pollution itself is not the main problem. Mario, you witnessed this object at the airstrip, correct? It is a shine sprite. Shine sprites are the source of power on Isle Delfino. They used to gather in great numbers at the Shine Gate, but the graffiti incident has polluted the island and most of the shine sprites have fled. There is no longer any power to support the peaceful lifestyle of the islanders. It is most pitiable. The only way to ensure the return of the shine sprites is to keep the island from becoming any dirtier. The perpetrator is likely at work even as we speak. And you, Mario, are being treated as a criminal. Tomorrow we must do our best to resolve this situation.
Go straight that way. You can't miss the mess now. Your first job's to get rid of all that ugliness. And remember, we'll be watching you, pal. We'll know if you start slacking off.
Alright, so that was the cutscene right there. It's kind of weird thinking about it, how Super Mario Sunshine is the only Mario game in the series to have full-on, like, voice acting in the cutscenes. Unless I'm wrong, maybe I missed one, but it's kind of weird. But anyway, yeah, Mario is on parole, we have to clean up all this goop, which we didn't even do, it's the misdeeds of another person, and yeah, this story kind of reminds me of Sonic Adventure 2, like, so much, because they're basically accusing me for the deeds of this other dude, named, surprisingly, Shadow Mario. And he looks nothing like me. I mean, he has the same form as me, but he is completely blue. It's like all these people are colorblind. Like, how the heck do I know it's not you? Like, you got the mustache. You got my mustache. You're blue. It could be you. Screw you. Anyway, alright, so what we're gonna do is, let's see, we can actually slide over this way, but I'm gonna spray on the ground right here. Here we go. Slide into your DMs like, yo, what's up, Peach? Oh, Mario, you're okay after all. I just knew you would be. Yep. Oh, my God. Someone missed the toilet right here. Let himself out a nice steamy dump. And why is the sky so dark, huh? It's not sun-drenched. This is hardly my idea of a relaxing vacation, Mario. I want to go home right now. Oh my God. Seriously though, look at that. There's steam coming out of that freaking dump right there. It's disgusting. But, yeah. Okay, I know this sounds really bad, but seriously, whenever I saw the goop when I was younger, I always thought of chocolate mousse. Like, look at this stuff. This looks like it's something from, like, a chocolate mousse cake. Like, I could just eat it up. It looks yummy. Yummy. But then, since I was talking about, what is it? A dump, I probably should stop. But anyway! It's a freaking parasite from someone's dump. Oh my God! Alright, so we gotta clean it right now. This man needs a colon cleanse. Let's go. Get that out of here. Get that crap out of here. Right now. But seriously. Epic Mickey just sprayed all over the place just to get revenge for me not finishing off his playthrough of his game. But anyway, kill that dude. And oh my God!
Princess, look! On the statue's head!
Mario?
Oh my God, I swear this girl is just as colorblind as Amy. Oh snap, what the heck are you doing? Yo! Come back! It's Mr. Steel Girl. Okay, no, seriously though. Okay, we gotta chase after this dude right here. And, yeah, he takes Princess Peach, but all you gotta do is just spray ahead of you. Spray him enough times, and then, oh, bottoms up. We get our Nicki Minaj back. You shouldn't be allowed to use tools like that. Alright, here we go. Peach is right there. Let's talk to her real quick. Mario, I'm sure I saw that person out on the airstrip. I'm positive he's responsible for all this. Chase him. Alright, we gotta go after him. go after Mr. Steel Girl. I hate myself for making that reference. But there he is right there. All right. Hello? No. I'm faster than you. Look at this. What the heck? Look at that! He even put the Mickey Mouse ears on the M. Like, look at that. That's definitely Mickey from my pinky. But anyway, alright, so what you gotta do right here is spray the graffiti and then jump inside and blue scud dude, we can too. Alright, I need to stop right now. But anyway, we're going on to Bianco Hills. So this is episode 1, we're gonna go to Road to the Big Windmill, and yeah, this is the first stage in this game. Kinda crazy, but oh, there's a fiend right there. The guy who's making us go through all this hell of having to go through this game. But honestly, this game is really, really awesome. It's one of my favorites. And, speaking of question of the day, like I was before, let me actually go into that and kind of give my opinion on what I think about this game. This is actually one of my favorite Mario games in the series, like 3D Mario games. I actually have to say, I do like it a lot more than Super Mario 64. I know some people may disagree with me on that, but... You know, when I played Super Mario 64, I played it after I played, you know, games like this and Galaxy. So I never really did play Super Mario 64 when it first came out. So I think that's why I don't really, like, you know, why I like this game a lot more compared to, like, most people who like Super Mario 64 and treat it like, you know, it's a godlike game. Because, you know, I played the other games, they improved so much, and I just felt that Super Mario 64 was really, really slippery and glitchy. For my taste. But this game is really, really awesome. It's not my favorite out of the Mario series, but it's definitely one of my favorites because I grew up with this game as a child and absolutely loved it. Okay, this dude is spitting out chocolate balls, giving out the chocolate rain. We're just gonna go and spray right here on this little nest. Alright, there we go. That backflip though! Alright, so spray right into his mouth. I'm gonna go ahead and go into first person view right here. You can actually do that. Go into first person mode and have more accuracy with your aim. So if you want to do that, you can. Anyway, once we defeat him. Alright! Very nice! Mission has been completed. We make the bridge reappear. Like, my god, it's so freaking weird. Alright. Oh my god! That dude was ginormous. Did you see that? Good lord. Anyway, dive into there. We have Mario, all dirty, man. Mario's such a dirty boy. But there we go, we got ourselves our second shine in this game. Actually, really, really easy. The first few missions in this game are going to be really easy, and I'll probably do about 3 or 4 more after this. But each episode, I'm going to have probably around 30 minutes long or something like that, because I like to have, you know, I like to have a bit of meat in my stuff. Anyway, dive into the stage once again. We're going to go on to the third mission. Yeah, I have to say, though, probably my favorite thing about this game is Flood, which I know some people kind of hate, some people love, but, you know, I don't know. It seemed like more people actually started to like Super Mario Sunshine the more people started doing playthroughs on YouTube of it, because I do remember back then when people did hate it a lot, but then when everyone started doing it, like, and, you know, on YouTube, that's when everyone was like, oh my god, I gotta try this game out, it's so much fun, and, you know, I don't know. I really do like this game a lot. Anyway, we're gonna be careful here. Let's see. We're supposed to go up to the top of the windmill and meet Petey Piranha, so let's go ahead and do that. Yeah, I gotta say though, this game is absolutely gorgeous. One of the most beautiful games on the Nintendo GameCube. Like, the water, I think probably the most stunning thing about this game is the water. Because that's one thing, what is it, a lot of people make a big deal of out of this game, because it's kind of like a tropical game, so there's a lot of water all over the place. And they did a terrific job making it look absolutely stunning. In fact, I have to say, the water in this game actually looks better than the water in Super Mario Galaxy. I know that sounds crazy, because Galaxy was like on the Nintendo Wii and whatnot, but good lord, just look at how beautiful it is. Like. We're gonna go to, like, the next area that we're gonna go to is full of water, and it just looks so gorgeous. Anyway, avoid these chocolate mousse balls. Would you like some chocolate balls? The Negro can promise. Okay, that's that. Alright, most effective way to get up here, though, in my opinion, is just use the hover nozzle and hover over this goop so that we don't fall into it. And, that way we can clean up a good amount. And if you fall into, or if you come into these, like, sprinklers right there, they instantly fill up your flood, water tank, so make sure to take advantage of that. Anyway, see right here? Look at this. So freaking useful. Like, oh, God! Okay, I flew straight into that. But seriously, flood is so freaking awesome. Oh yeah, by the way, if you want, you can spray these M's right here in certain stages, and you get yourself blue coins. Now, blue coins can get you pretty much like extra sunshines or shine sprites, whatever they're called, shine sprites. You can get extra ones at a certain lighthouse that you'll unlock soon. But I'm not going to be collecting all the blue coins. It's not a 100% playthrough because, you know, play games for fun, and I do not find the blue coin missions fun at all. In fact, I find them really, really tedious and just annoying, so I'm not going to be doing that. But anyway, we're going to come over here and make our way towards Petey Piranha. Dive into him. Good lord, kid. This man's having a tantrum right here. This is my favorite part. Oh my god. He's just like, oh, snap. Alright, so here we are on our first boss in this game. We have to face off against Petey Piranha, which is honestly one of the easiest bosses in this game. He is so freaking easy. Alright, so what you gotta do right here, what you gotta do in this mission is you gotta fill this dude's mouth up with water so that you can fill it up and then booty mounts on his belly button, and that's how you knock him out. This dude's so freaking annoying. Like, he'll try to change direction and whatnot, so you'll have a hard time actually reaching him. You see right there? Fill him up, then come up here. Oh, if I can actually stop slipping, and there we go! Booty mounts into that belly button. Yeah. Make that water all come out. But seriously, this man needs a nice colon cleanse. That's why we gotta spray in his mouth. Because he's just letting it out of the wrong hole. Wait, what the heck? Close his mouth right there. I don't know what the heck's going on, but seriously, this boss is so easy, man. So freaking easy. Alright, gargle. Gargle on this Listerine. Alright, time for bed. And boom, shakalaka! I swear, though, this boss is kind of funny. Like, what the heck? They gave this dude such a ginormous belly button, man. I swear. Alright. He's gonna spray right now. Oh! I think I sprayed on top of his head or something like that. I think that makes him, like, what is it? I don't know. Stop having his mouth open. There we go. Do it one last time. Here we go. Alright. If I could actually get up here. Oh my god! What the heck? There we go. And now, see right there, he couldn't handle the cleanse, so now he just turns into chocolate mousse, and oh god! What the heck? I just kept jumping into it and just kept hurting myself. It's kind of funny. But anyway, now that we're done here, we can go ahead and dive! Freaking dive into the shine sprite, Aria. Are you kidding me? I'm failing so hard. There we go! Dive into the shine sprite, and we have now collected our third shine sprite. So yeah, pretty easy boss. It kind of took me a bit longer than I thought it would, but I kind of failed a couple times. But there we go. Our first boss has been defeated, and oh god. Someone left a ginormous black dump right here, so we gotta go back and clean that up. It's time for Ron Jeremy to go on the job. Let's go! Skadoosh! Seriously, though, I will never unsee that. Like, the moment I realized how those two look so similar, like Mario and Ron J, I was just like, oh my god. Can never be unseen! Now we have one covered in oil right here. If I can actually get out of this sludge so that I can do the backflip. Alright, so we gotta spray in his mouth once again. Open wide! Alright. Yeah, we gotta run into these guys a lot. We run into this guy a lot, and then I think we run into Petey Piranha a lot. It's kind of funny how they do actually recycle bosses here quite a couple of times. But, oh, man, what the heck? Okay, there we go. Now we just gotta do it, I believe, two more times, and then we're gonna unlock the next area. I just thought about it. It's like we're clearing out the thinner on this stage right here. And then it's gonna make a place appear. Like, ah, I didn't even think about that. Like, I swear, Epic Mickey was so inspired off this game. Anyway, let's go ahead and spray into the Epic Mickey M right there. But if you actually want to, you can come into the lighthouse and you can talk to these guys. And welcome, welcome! I suppose you're here for that. Yes, very good. That means I will require 10 Baloo coins from you. What, this? What's this? Not even 10 coins, then you get nothing. I can't drop my prices that low. That would be madness. You'll have to come back again, I'm afraid. See you later. So yeah, the 10 Baloo coins are used to buy yourself Shine Sprites, because you can buy, I believe it's like 20 Shine Sprites, because they're like 200 Baloo coins, so that's how you actually 100% the game. But honestly, like I said, I don't see it being worth it. But we're not going to go to the next area right there, because we still have some more business to take care of in Bianca Hills. We're going to hop over that dude, and let's see if we can get a nice freeze frame. Nice. I'm going to try and do that from now on. Like, whenever I try to enter into one of these portals, I'm going to try and do like a weird trick or something like that so I can get a funny freeze frame. But anyway, now we're going to go on to the third mission of this stage right here. I'm going to go to the Hillside Cave Secret. And we're going to actually go into one of the special platforming missions right here, which should be interesting. But by the way, you can actually talk to this dude right here if you want, if he'll be so kind. Hey, I think you're in need of a pair of my special sunshades. Ooh, well, then again, maybe you're not ready. My body is so ready. Come on, you need to spend a bit more time here on Isle Delfino. Come on back when you think you're ready for a pair. See ya. Yeah, apparently if you get like, I believe it's like 20 sunshines or something like that, shine sprites, he'll give you sunglasses, so, you know, that way the stage won't be as bright. But honestly, I like the environment being bright, because, I don't know, sunshine feels like so cheery and whatnot. Like, it's one of the brighter, like, games in the Mario series, and I like that a lot. I like how, you know, it just puts you in a good mood whenever you play this game. Whenever you visit Bianco Hills, you're just like, hey, this is life, man. But, okay, so what we're supposed to be doing is going to the cave with the secret. I'm gonna come right here. But, I would really, yeah, let me know in the comments below. Would you all like to see a Super Mario Sunshine sequel? I really, really want to see one, because I thought Flood was an awesome mechanic that they added to this game and added so much to the gameplay and platforming, and would love to see him come back. Like, I know Miyamoto said that the next 3D Mario game that he's probably going to be working on is going to be the Galaxy series, but, oh god, freaking Mr. Stereo Girl is back. Took our Flood. So now we have to go through one of the floodless missions. But yeah, as I was saying, you know, I know Miyamoto said that he wants to work on Galaxy next, like another Galaxy game. What the? Oh god! Wow! Already starting off perfectly. Like, oh my god. Just had a fail right in the beginning of the stage. But I know Miyamoto said that he wants to work on, you know, Galaxy next, but seriously, I would love to see a sequel to this game, or even a remake. Like, I would love to see, you know, like, Sunshine be on the Wii U, kind of like Wind Waker was. Oh god, be careful there. Yeah, these stages are actually really annoying, because, I mean, they have, like, nice acapella music and all that stuff, and it just makes you feel all giddy inside, but these stages are so freaking slippery, man. I hate them. Like, it's mostly because, I don't know, there's something about Mario. It seems like he's kind of on ice or something like that. And it really makes it hard to sometimes do platforming ground here. I'm going to skip on this, or maybe I can get it. No, I'm not underneath it. Alright, screw that. I'm just going to die for it. And there we go. Get ourselves the sunshine. I keep saying sunshine. I mean, shine sprite. Dang it. There we go. That was our fourth one right there. But yeah, let me know in the comments below, though. Would you like to see Super Mario Sunshine remake, or would you like to see, you know, like, a sequel to the game? Because I think that it'd be really cool if, you know, Galaxy took a while or whatever. Like, you know, if they're going to spend a ton of time, you know, making, like, you know, Super Mario Galaxy 3, like, a great game or something like that, give us a game in the meantime, like how they're doing with Zelda. So basically make an HD remake of Sunshine. Like, that'd be so freaking awesome, man. Like, I'd love that so much. Especially with the Wii U gamepad. I think it would really take great advantage of, the Wii U's hardware. But anyway, now we're going to do one last mission before we end off this episode right here. We're going to be going on to the red coins of Windmill Village. So, yeah, this mission's kind of easy. Just got to collect all 8 red coins and then we'll be done. But seriously, the red coin missions are kind of annoying too. Because some of them are going to be in like more difficult areas, which, I mean, you should expect, but some of them are pretty annoying. Anyway, I'm going to actually come over this way, because I believe this is the faster route. Alright, so what we need to do is, okay, get that right there. Alright, good deal. Alright, so now that we're done there, we can come over this way. Look at that. Oh my god, I love how acrobatic Mario is in this game. He is like so freaking awesome. Alright, now we gotta come over here. I don't even know if they have, like, the spin jump in Super Mario Galaxy. Like, do they? All I know is that they have the spin, but I don't know about the spin jump. And oh god! It's freaking Sonic Wind trying to chase after me right here. You can actually spray those guys and make them disappear, but it's kind of hard to do that. So what I do is just kind of avoid them. But they will screw you over if you let them, so be careful about that. See right here? Look at this. Okay, look at this. Where the heck are you going, son? Where the heck are you going? Oh god! See there? I was too slow. I couldn't avoid the Sonic Wind. So freaking annoying though. Alright. So what I'm gonna do right here is blow on this, or spray on this, so we can go ahead and spin this platform over here. That way, we can actually do the hover nozzle. There we go. Hey! Not bad. Alright, so we've gotten 7 of these so far. Alright. Oh god! Dodge him with scale. And there we go. That is the 8th red coin. Not bad. Alright. I'm gonna come over here. Be careful. I'm gonna see if I can actually dive into this shine sprite. That'd be so freaking hilarious if I could actually do that. Okay, here we go. No! Oh god! I missed it! Oh my god, what an epic fail. Like, I was trying so hard to get it perfectly, and then, nope. Snap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes rapidy chokes. He's so mad he won't get up. Alright, I need to come back up here again. Alright, let's try this again. I am going to get this. Like, I swear, I will get this. I am going to dive into that shine sprite like I would into the booty, and we will get this. There we go! Hey! Not bad. So there we go, we got ourselves 5 shine sprites in this episode. I think we actually did quite a lot of progress in this episode. So I'm going to go ahead and end it off here. But, oh, look at that. We even unlocked a new area. So we got 3 worlds that we can actually go to if we want. But, you know, we're going to finish up Delfino Plaza in the next episode. And then probably start off on, that next area. But, if you did enjoy this video, make sure to go ahead and hit that like button. It really, really helps out a ton. Can't thank you all enough for all the support. Like I said, let's see if we can hit 3,500 likes. That'd be so freaking awesome. And actually stick around for the end of the episode, because, like, right after this ending, because I have a little something special I did just for this playthrough. And if y'all like it, let me know in the comments below, because if y'all do, maybe I'll do it for every playthrough that I do. Like, do a specific little thing for each playthrough that I do on my channel. But anyway, yeah, let me know in the comments below. Also, question of the day, what you all think about this game overall. Would you all like to see a Super Mario Sunshine sequel or remake? And, yeah, would love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. But anyway, thank you all again for watching. See you all! Have a good day! Peace, Cobonomites! Thank you.